morning. Welcome to St. Maximilian Kolbe Parish. Our announcements, we have two announcements. There will be additional confession times on Thursday, February 22nd. Please see the bulletin for times and locations. And there will be a second collection today for Black, Native, and Hispanic missions. Today is the first Sunday of Lent. Mindful of his covenant, the Lord promises never to destroy creation again by flood waters. The waters of baptism bring salvation and forgiveness through the death of Christ. After fasting 40 days and being put to the test, Jesus begins his public ministry. The readings today are number 809 in the Glory and Praise Book, and our entrance hymn is 272, Led by the Spirit.
Welcome to the service this morning. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery.
Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Grant Almighty God, through the yearly observance of Holy Lent, that we may grow in understanding of the riches hidden in Christ, and by worthy conduct pursue their effect. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The liturgy for children. Oh, you are the only one. This is happening. Maybe children felt the day I teach them in Swahili, Baridi Sana, very cold. Okay, what do you choose? You go with the teacher, you go to mom, or you stay with me? Okay, we bless you, Father, Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our first reading is from the book of Genesis. God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "See, I am now establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, all the birds and the various tamed and wild animals that were with you and came out of the ark. I will establish my covenant with you that never again shall all bodily creatures be destroyed by the waters of a flood. There shall not be another flood to devastate the earth." God added, "This is the sign that I am giving for all ages to come of the covenant between me and you and every living creature with you. I set my bow in the clouds to serve as a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow appears in the sky, in the clouds, I will recall the covenant I have made between me and you and all living things, so that the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all mortal beings." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, Christ suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the Spirit. In it, he also went to preach to the spirits in prison who had once been disobedient, while God patiently waited in the days of Noah during the building of the ark, in which a few persons, eight in all, were saved through water. This prefigured baptism, which saves you now. It is not a removal of dirt from the body, but an appeal to God for a clear conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers subject to him. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The Spirit drove Jesus out into the desert, and he remained in the desert for 40 days, tempted by Satan. He was among wild beasts, and the angels ministered to him. After John had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee proclaiming the gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. The gospel of the Lord.
The Gospels of the first week of Lent always is on temptations of our Lord. We know the readings are chosen in the course of the season, and depending on where we have catechumens, also readings can change, but we have the readings of the temptations of the Lord. We have also Transfiguration comes in. Our Lord meeting the Samaritan woman at the well also is another one. And also the healing of the blind man Bartimaeus. Of course, each year we go with a different evangelist. But this year we look at Mark. Mark is the one we are reading on the temptations of the Lord. Soon after his baptism, we are told he came to the desert where he's led by the Holy Spirit. It's very strange to see at baptism the Spirit of the Lord comes on our Lord, and the Father acknowledges him as his only Son for us to listen to him. And the same Spirit immediately takes him to the desert to be tempted by the devil. Of course, the Spirit of God is one. There cannot be one to come at baptism and another bad one taking him to the desert. It's the same Spirit. But as we look at the account of Mark differs, it differs with the others. What you see in the account of Mark, you don't have the dialogue between our Lord and the devil. In Matthew, the year we read Matthew, you hear the Lord is in the desert, and the devil tells him, if you are son of God, change these stones or rocks to be bread, or throw yourself to the ground and the angel will save you. All this doesn't come with Mark. Mark's dialogue is not there. Jesus is taken to the desert, and all of a sudden we are seeing our Lord coming in. And he's coming with the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the good news. The announcing of the good news or the gospel, the time was appropriate for him to bring these understanding to his listeners and to us. To repent and believe in the good news of truth about God, good news of hope, good news of peace of God and peace among his people, good news of God's promises to his people, this good news on salvation, and it's good news of immortality. In quotes, end of Easter is a clear sign for us that our Lord has opened the gates of eternal life for us. Our Lord has given us and will continue to give us what we need to stand strong. God is always at work and within us and will always remain with us. St. Paul says, I can do all things in him who strengthened me. So his faith and his strength is in the Lord, and he doesn't shy to say about that. At times, life is a struggle, and we know, between evil and the grace of God. Things like selfishness, holiness sometimes come that kind of conflict with one another. Our time on earth will be successful in the measure in which we try to retain and remain the grace of God. In scripture story, we know the fall of humanity and salvation are two contrasting reactions, which we'll say came in with temptation. The first human, Adam and Eve, imagine as preferring their own inclination rather than obeying the God who created them. In Jesus, whom we are told the second Adam in his humanity, he's of course God and Son of God, the Savior is contrary to the first Adam. He beats temptation, remains faithful to God the Father as his Father required him. St. Paul reflects on this, on how these two choices affect us. Adam's sin brought troubles to all, but we are saved and offered new life because of fidelity of Son of God. This brings us to the temptation and he beats the temptation. In Adam, we were defeated. In the Lord, we are victors. Temptation, in one form or another, is unavoidable in our life. Our really growth as Christian maturity starts when we acknowledge and accept that our vocation is struggling with temptation, things that can derail the human race away from God, and our behavior and attitude towards them give an example of Jesus. Remain faithful to our eternal Father. Like Jesus, we should let the Holy Spirit lead us in the desert of Lent, where we can confront whatever trouble our lives, and like him, to bring triumph over them. That is the freedom and dignity of the children of God, which we all share, through the sacraments, especially in baptism and also in the sacrament of penance. As a church, we are on a journey which will end with Easter. I want to share with you those three things we practice of time of Lent. We know there is prayer, there is almsgiving, and there is fasting. Our Holy Father Francis shared sometimes on fasting. There are many ways of looking at fasting. So when we talk of fasting, maybe you say go without food, but there are other things we can go without. And I will share these. They will be shared in the bulletin of end of next week, or rather the coming Sunday. He gives 11 points. I will share them here. If you want to fast, fast from hurting words and say kind words to people. Fast from sadness and be filled with gratitude. Fast from anger and be filled with patience. Fast from pessimism and be filled with hope. Fast from worries and trust God. Fast from complaints, contemplate in simplicity. Fast from pressures and be prayerful. Fast from bitterness, fill your heart with joy. Fast from selfishness and be compassionate. Fast from grudges and be reconciled. Fast from words, be silent and listen. All this is said to you and also to me. I believe
in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For our sin and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was with him, Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the very word of God, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Father in heaven, your people come to you as we come to this journey. We come with our petitions.
That all baptized Christians faithfully proclaim the reign of God and turn to him in every temptation, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That political leaders avoid temptations of power and greed and serve with sincere generosity those they represent, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That all who face obstacles, be they physical or emotional, grow in faith-filled stamina and determination, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That all who are on their journey to the Easter sacraments experience the welcome and support of their communities, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That the members of this assembly, in prayer and fasting, be drawn ever more deeply into the Paschal mystery, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That we support each other as we journey toward the future of our cluster, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For Clara Capone Rizzo, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all those listed in our Book of Intentions and our bulletin prayer list, for those in our memorial book, for our benefactors, and for all that is in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for
us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Into night we will follow you, we will love you age to age.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become our bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your for the praise and glory of the King, for our good to the most holy Church.
Give us the right disposition, Lord, we pray, to make these offerings. For with them we celebrate the beginning of this venerable and sacred time, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. By abstaining 40 long days from earthly food, he consecrated through this fast the pattern of our Lenten observance. And by overturning all the snares of the ancient serpent, taught us to cast out the leaven of malice, so that celebrating worthily the Paschal mystery, we might pass over at last to the eternal Paschal feast. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, and from the word beginning, are ceaselessly at work so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings, and pour out on them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though once we were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death, and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth, to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessings, broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more, giving you thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our sure peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead. And looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciled to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those whom you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body of Christ who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis, our Pope, and Salvator, our Bishop, help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints, in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly commend to your mercy. Then, freed at last from the wounds of corruption, and made fully into new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God.
sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life. Say to my Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust. He will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the flower will never capture you. The famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness, your shield. He will raise you up on eagle's wings.
the sun and hold you in the palm of his hand. You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. A thousand fold above you, you shall not come. He will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angel he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you rest your foot against a stone, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. And hold you in the palm of his hand.
Let us pray. Renewed now with the heavenly bread, by which faith is nourished and hope increased and charity strengthened, we pray, O Lord, that we may learn to hunger for Christ, the true and living bread, and strive to live by every word which proceeds from your mouth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We bow for blessings. May bountiful blessing, O Lord, we pray, come down upon your people, that hope may grow in tribulation, virtue be strengthened in temptation, and eternal redemption be assured through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Mighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Mass is ended. Go in peace. Thanks be to God. And St. Michael prayer.
Protection against the wickedness and sins of the devil. May God rebuke you, we humbly pray, and do now, O grace of the Holy Ghost, by the power of God, trust into the hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruins of his souls.
The pigs. Who's the next pigs?
Our final hymn of praise is going to be 760, Lead Me, Lord.
Can fill.